हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ श्रेया एंड आई एम अ लीगल इंटर्न एट लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी। आई एम परस्यूइंग BLLB ऑनर्स फ्रॉम लॉ कॉलेज देहरादून उत्तरांचल यूनिवर्सिटी। आई एम करेंटली इन 7th सेमेस्टर, सो आई एम वेरी ग्लैड टू बी इंटर्निंग विद लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी विच हैज़ गिवन मी हु हैव गिवन मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ प्रेजेंटिंग टू यू गाइज विद दिस वीडियो। सो द पर्पज ऑफ दिस वीडियो विल बी टू मेक यू गाइज अवेयर अबाउट सम ऑफ द legal maxims used in the legal field. So in this video I'll be discussing with 5 legal maxims used in the legal field. So basically you can refer to my previous video also, which explains another 5 legal maxims. So yeah, let's begin. The first maxim here will be res ipsa loquitur. It means that thing speaks for itself. That means the matter itself reveals the truth. It indicates that the event itself explains that the defendant was negligent and it relieves the plaintiff of the burden of proof. This is a very common example and we have various examples in this maxim. You must be knowing this. So res ipsa loquitur means that thing speaks for itself. For example, there is a situation in a room, a crime has been committed, someone has stabbed the other person, and there is a dead body lying in the corner, and the other person is seen standing there holding a bloodstained knife in his or her hand. So definitely in such a scenario we can say that these things speak for itself, that the person standing with the knife is the one who has committed the murder. So yeah, this was it, res ipsa loquitur. So the second maxim for today will be nemo dat quod non habet. You must have heard this maxim earlier also, that no one can give what he does not own. That is, no one can give what he has not got with himself. That is, it is important that the person should be the owner of that particular thing to give that particular thing to another person. Ownership is the main essence of this legal maxim. This particular legal maxim is applied where a person has no ownership right over a thing. That is, for example, if a person have gifted a property to another person, but later on it is found that the property which was gifted was not originally with the person who has gifted it, it belongs to some another person. So thus in such a case this transaction will be void ab initio. There will be no rights generated here, or neither to the buyer nor to the seller. You can only give what you have the ownership of. So the next maxim here is extra territorium jus dicenti impure non paratus. That is, the orders powers of the person who uses its dominance or services or jurisdiction beyond its territory cannot be executed fearlessly. That is, if someone exercises his power beyond its jurisdiction, it will have no meaning and will be worthless. For example, if a judge decides on a case or a court decides on a case for which that judge or court has no jurisdiction, so such particular judgment will have no value. It will be worthless. It will not be considered in the eyes of law. It is important that a person should act within his jurisdiction, within its powers, and not go beyond that. Hope you guys understood this maxim. So the next maxim is also one of very common very common maxim, and it is very important that you guys should know about it. It is ubi jus ibi remedium. That is, for every right there is a remedy. Where there is a right, there is a remedy. And if there is a violation of a particular right, that person or that or anybody whose right has been violated, there will be provided for a remedy. There will be given a remedy for that. This maxim has been developed from the law of tort, and one of the leading case here is of D.K. Basu versus State of Bengal. It is a very important maxim. So the last maxim for today will be furiosis furi sui pervenir. Furiosis furi furie sui pervenir. That is, if a man of unsound mind commits a crime, he or she shall not be responsible for that particular offense and will not be liable for any punishment for that crime. Here we can say that the biggest punishment a madman or a lunatic person is given with is his madness alone. His madness is itself the biggest punishment for that person. Such thing has also been given under section 84 of IPC. Thus we can moreover we can say that the biggest punishment that a madman is bestowed upon is his madness alone. So this is also a very popular maxim and used very frequently in legal field, that a madman or a lunatic person of or a person of unsound mind cannot commit a crime and he will be always exempted from his punishment. However, it is important to note that a person should be of unsound mind at that particular point of time where he has committed that crime. If a person is sometimes if a person is sometimes of unsound mind, whereas on the other part of time or the other time he is perfectly fine, and if he has committed a crime during that time period when he is absolutely normal, he will be liable for the punishment of that crime, though he may be of unsound mind later on. It is important that at the commission of at that point of time where the crime is committed, he should be of unsound mind. Only then he will be exempted from the punishment. So this was it for today. Hope you guys like these maxims, and please do ask a question if you have any, and give feedback and like, share and subscribe. So thank you guys.